Okay, so we heard a lot about education, you know.
Yeah.
How do you, it seems like I hear two things. One is we talk about the great intellectual capital that Minnesota has, but on the other hand, we talk about how we're apparently not producing the right qualified workforce. How do you kind of reconcile those two different things that people seem to be talking about?
Yeah, well, we do create very creative kids, and I think we have a lot of successes in our education system. We do need to focus on particularly at the higher education level, matching up the jobs that we're going to need with the kind of training that we're providing. And we need to have that conversation between business and our higher education institutions. That's critical. But I don't think an exclusive focus on just science and math is going to lead to the kind of creativity that we also need to create a great workforce in Minnesota. And our testing environment in this state, which doesn't allow time for things like arts or things like science and engineering, and those hands-on kind of experiences are really getting in the way of producing the kind of workers we're going to need in the future.
We also hear a lot, we tend to hear amongst politicians and in St. Paul, kind of this demonization, and maybe this is my own take, but of the University of Minnesota and the Minsky system, you know? And we talk about all the great things that we've done, but it seems like they seem to be the perfect whipping boy for some of our economic development problems. They're not spinning out enough companies, they're not doing enough real research, they're not producing the right types of workers. Like, how do we get higher ed, if that's true, how do we get higher ed to do those sort of things?
Yeah, well, I mean, I think you're first of all right that we have had this culture of demonization of education in general and of public investment in education, including the U of M and Minsky. I think what we need to do is have a conversation of eliminating some of the bureaucracy. I think that's true, very true. The central office at Minsky is too big and we could move those resources elsewhere. I also think it's very true that the way the bureaucracy works at the University of Minnesota, compared to the University of Wisconsin, does get in the way of translating R&D good ideas into the private sector. It just takes too long. So there's conversations we can have about making that more efficient, mm-hmm. but we absolutely can't say that we're not going to be investing in higher education at the University of Minnesota. In fact, we need to invest more money there because that really is the future economic, one of the big economic engines of this state.
And my last question for you is that they passed the Angel Investment Tax Credit, they passed the R&D Tax Credit. Is there anything else? Is that just the end or is that the beginning? Is there anything that we can do within our tax system to incentivize the type of biotech jobs, medical device jobs that people here are interested in?
Yeah, I think it is a really important first step. I think we could probably expand that angel investor tax credit, but I also think that some of the things they were talking about, our business tax climate isn't the way it should be, but it can't just be by solving the business tax climate by just cutting business taxes and not doing anything else to restructure our tax system. What we need is an entire overhaul of our tax system to make it more fair, more stable, and more business friendly.